In this video, I will show you step-by-step how to create a simple but elegant-looking search box using Tailwind CSS. At the end of the video, you will understand much more clearly why we use Tailwind CSS instead of classic CSS. And I will also show step-by-step how we do not exclude this tone and how we include it in the input field. In this video, our goal is to create an impressive search box in terms of both design and functionality using Tailwind CSS. Let's open a new file and start writing the HTML skeleton codes. First, let's write standard HTML5 codes on our page. Let's write a logical title called search box. Since this will be a Tailwind CSS, we need to transfer the CDN of Tailwind CSS here. In other words, we do this in order for it to recognize the codes we write as class on the page. So what is Tailwind CSS? Tailwind CSS is actually known as a modular and flexible CSS framework. In classic CSS writing, we have to define separate classes and rules for each style. This can cause complexity in large projects. Tailwind CSS, on the other hand, allows us to define styles quickly with ready-made helper classes. In this way, we can write classes directly in HTML without writing repetitive CSS classes, and we can see what we want to create much faster. When we save our page and look at it, you will see that there is nothing right now, a white page. First of all, let's add an input field in the page, and let's add a placeholder to this input field, the search box. So when we see the search box, it will say search in the middle by default. When we save the page and look at it, we can see that there is such an image. Now we will improve this. First, let's add some classes to the body tag and make the page look a bit nicer. I want the background of the body to be gray. I added BG Gray 600 so that we can make the work we will do in the input field a little more prominent. But this is too far left. Let's center this a little more. By adding these codes, we ensure that the input field is centered both horizontally and vertically. We will also add a button to this input option. Let's add our button immediately, and there will be an icon inside the button. It can be an arrow icon, it can be a search icon. We can do these. Let's write a search for now and save and see. Look, here is the button. We will change the background of the button. Let's make the button a little more beautiful. We will do this again by taking advantage of the features of Tailwind CSS. I've added a few classes, but what's even more important is that we've changed the background color. Let's make it an orange background, and I want the icon, or whatever the text is, to be white. So that's what we're going to do. Without wasting any time, let's add an icon to search. Let our icon be the arrow icon. Let's do this with SVG codes. This will look a bit more aesthetic than a text. I'm going to enlarge the page a little bit. The search part looks a bit bad. Let's make it a little more beautiful. When we have a powerful tool like Tailwind CSS, it can be annoying for search to look like this. I'm making the width of the input section full. I've made some padding adjustments. I've made the edges a little bit softer by making it rounded full because it's a corner. And I've also canceled this outline effect that we get when we click on it. It can sometimes look bad depending on the location. So you can cancel this line by saying focus outline none. I'm saving it this way and let's see. When I save and look at it, we're heading towards a nice place. But at this point, the button is out. We need to bring the button in. So we need to take it inside the white area of the input field. So it should be somewhere on the right side there. The positioning of the button inside the search box is important for user experience. The button should be inside the box, that is, inside the input. It allows the search process to be performed quickly without straining the user's eyes. Integrating the button with the box using the absolute class of Tailwind CSS serves this purpose. This way, instead of the button appearing as an independent element on the outside, it appears as a part of the box and creates a more elegant design. I immediately add absolute to the button. When I give absolute, we will take it inside the input field. But right now in the middle, I'm setting it to 0 from the right, and I can set it to 0 from the top. As you can see, it's gone. The reason is that we have not given a relative. I will add a div on the input field. Thanks to the class we will give to this div, we will trap the button inside the input field. Therefore, by calling it relative, I ensure that the button stays inside the input field. Let's give a width of width 60 and finally determine the width of our jersey. The button looks angular at the moment. As we can see from this part, we can round the button. Look how beautiful it looks. When we get to the search section, we can type anything to search. And when we hover over the button, we can click on it to search. But as a user experience, it would be much more logical to change this color when you hover over the button. To show that this is a button, we will therefore give the button a hover effect. When it hovers, I want the background to be black when we hover over it with the mouse. When I save and look at it, we can see that the background is black when we hover over it. And it's clear to a user that this is a button. Yes, in this video, we learned how to create a search box in a simple and effective way using Tailwind CSS. Step by step, we designed a modern and user-friendly search box using HTML and the basic features of Tailwind CSS. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. See you in the next tutorial.